Kevin Love is the most relatable basketball player right now. He's just you know what? Screw this. He's like, I hate the job.
He ain't the first person to be upset at their job. I am not mad at you, K Love, at all. Let's start the show.
He is Jalen Rose. I'm David Jacoby. We are Jalen and Jacoby. Though? What is it that
we
do?
We give the people what they want.
We have a huge guest today, my favorite prospect in the NFL draft, what I consider to be the only sure thing in this draft. Kyle Pitts joins us just minutes away, but we start with big win for the Knicks last night. They went up against the Suns in the Garden. Huge win. Now, they didn't score more points than the Suns, but they were competitive throughout. They played great against one of the best teams in the NBA. Big win for the Knicks. What do you think about CP3 at the end of the game, Jalen Rose?
That is irrational confidence, and I'm glad you guys put that up there because you've given the Knicks another 7 wins this year in games that they lost, and I love that you're a Die Easy fandom lives eternally.
Look at that
shot. But this is all about CP3. This is all about a veteran remaking their image. Because once he went to Lob City, it was championship or bust. They didn't get it done. And it messed with his reputation. He went to Houston to play with James Harden. They didn't get it done. It messed with his reputation. He had to go to OKC, be a vet amongst young players, lead them to the playoffs, and take that victory along with the Suns going undefeated in the bubble that now put them in a position to add a vet like CP3. Now the casuals can appreciate the greatness that is Chris Paul. Just so happened that he hasn't won a championship, but he's a dynamic leader, a terrific performer, and he's clutch. Did you see that game when they shot? Play that shot again for Jacoby.
Yeah.
Because he thinks the Knicks won.
Did
Play
I see
that
it?
Shot again.
Did I see it?
Bang,
he scored their last 7 points. Look at this. Getting fouled everywhere. Derrick Rose fouling him, hitting it. Like, that was wild. And Jalen, I'm glad you brought the Suns because guess what? Don't look now. The Jazz lost 2 in a row to the Timberwolves. And the Suns could end up being the number one seed in the Western Conference. And a lot of that has to do with CP3, but also Devin Booker. Devin Booker was great in this one. Mikal Bridges contributed as well. And Jalen, let's just talk about that man right there for a second.
Absolutely. So the difference between Dame Lillard and Devin Booker is one of those guys is the best player, led his team to the playoffs almost every year and made clutch shots and made people validate his greatness along with this max deal. Devin Booker had the accolades and the performances. He has 70 points in the game already in his career, but he's yet to play in the playoffs. So therefore, people haven't validated his greatness. You and I both know that he's an elite performer, an all-star level player, all-NBA caliber guy. But now seeing him in the playoffs, a young player like Ayton, a young player like Bridges, being led by CP3, I know many of us don't feel like the Phoenix Suns are the favorite to win the championship, but now when I look at this squad, Jacoby, this ain't your normal first-round exit now. As a seed, as a 2 seed, they advancing this year, and I'm happy for Monty Williams.
And this team absolutely exceeded expectations. And one more thing about Devin Booker. He goes on a date with Kendall Jenner and then beats the Knicks in the Garden. That's a good weekend for Mr. Booker.
Today
Moving
was
on
a good
to
day.
To another team in the Western Conference, and that are the Denver Nuggets. Now, when Jamal Murray goes down, we just write them off. Jamal Murray goes down. We just completely write them off. Like, oh, they'll be an easy out. Teams will be jockeying for position to play them in the first round. They just keep getting buckets. Why have they been so successful even with Murray out?
In my Uncle Chuck D's voice, pieces in one big chess game. Yeah! So the dynamics of the Nuggets are clearly we're going to initiate our offense through this year's MVP, the Joker. And then Jamal Murray became a lights out kind of superstar in the bubble. Michael Porter Jr. was the third option offensively. He rumbled about not being happy about that this offseason, Jacoby. Now Murray is out. He becomes the second most important offensive player. And he's validating his concerns by the way he's balling. And a scorer like him, Jacoby, you see the catch and shoots. You're going to see him go one-on-one. But getting it within the team dynamic has been the growth in his game. You see dribble handoffs. You see him now doing backdoor cuts, moving without the ball, getting it from the offense. So now that he's able to do that and be efficient, you see him getting numbers like he got last night.
And if you learn how to move without the ball and you're on the same team as Jokic, you're going to get some easy buckets. And Michael Porter Jr. has proven that. And there's one thing I want to put to rest. All season long, we've probably named like 10 different people who are the MVP. It's over now. It's the Jokers. The stretch mark five got the MVP. It is over. We can talk about who's second, third, fourth. That's fine. But he is going to be the MVP, and the odds in Vegas back it up as well. Right now, minus 450. You have to bet $450 just to win 100 for Jokic to be the MVP. This one is over. I know you have a vote. Is there anyone else that could possibly get this from him?
I believe he's in pole position to get it done. Injuries and a shortened 72-game season will play a factor. But let's not ignore the top teams, players like CP3 and Donovan Mitchell, who have been terrific for the Suns and the Jazz. Of course, we're not going to ignore the injured players. And by the way, Joel Embiid has missed as many games as LeBron James, as Kawhi Leonard. So missed games have been a factor. So the Joker from the beginning of the season to now, top five in points, rebounds, and assists. The Nuggets have been consistently contending. Even without Murray, he's been dominant. He hasn't missed a game all season. Our guy that we fell in love with years ago before he went mainstream. His album was still, we were still playing this tape. You know what I'm saying? We was playing this CD. Now our guy that graduated and became presumptively the MVP of the league.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.